Hello students, greetings to one and all. Welcome to the webinar on the new examination pattern which is issued by the Central Board of Secondary Education for the academic session 2021-2022. Okay, so in this webinar we're going to discuss how the new examination pattern is going to be like and how the question paper is going to be framed. So the first thing, what is the new examination pattern? Okay, the new examination pattern would test the student on their analytical ability and reduce the role of rote learning. So in this, over here, rote learning means memorizing. So in this examination pattern, like in the previous classes, you used to cram and memorize whatever question and answers were given to you in the class. But this time, it's not going to be the same. This time, you're going to have different sort of questions, basically objective type of questions, and which will be as multiple choice questions. You will be given options to each question and you will have to answer accordingly. So this is how the new examination pattern is. So the main features of the new examination pattern: internal assessments in all subjects, entirely MCQ based question paper, and internal choice in the question paper. So internal assessment in all subject means your internal class activities, reading skills, writing skills, maybe like recitation and dictation and storytelling, debate, speech. These all can be considered as your internal assessment. Then this question paper is going to be entirely MCQ based question paper. And your next one is, what is MCQ based test? Now, as this is going to be the first time, so a multiple choice question is the meaning of MCQ, or is the full form of MCQ rather. A multiple choice question is composed of two parts: a stem that identifies the question or problem and the set of alternatives or possible answers that contain a key that is the best answer to the question. So you're going to get a question and then the question will be followed by four different options. Okay, so you'll have to choose the correct options. And a number of distractors — distractor means the options. All the options will look like that they are the same, but you'll have to be very vigilant while choosing the right answer. Now, over here you have a sample question. What type of sentence gives an order, a command, or a direction? Like, the question will be given like this, and then you will have four options down there, and you'll have to choose the right one. So the option will be declarative, interrogative, exclamatory, or imperative. So the right option is imperative, D part. So this is how the questions will be put forward. So the new half-yearly exam pattern will be based on reading skills, 5 marks, that is your comprehension or unseen passage. The unseen passage will be given and then the questions will be asked. Then writing skills, okay, it can be a letter writing, a story writing, a notice writing, whatever. Then you will have grammatical skills, questions from grammar, and then you will have the questions from your literature textbook. All these questions will be MCQ based, and then you'll have 10 marks for the internal assessment, which will overall be of 50 marks. So internal assessment, 10 marks, 5 marks for unit test. Okay, the unit test, I think that those were conducted during the session. Assessment for listening and speaking skills will be of 5 marks. Now the section A is going to be your reading skills, okay? And reading skill or passage similar to this will be given. Like, you can see the king of Iran has heard that Birbal was one of the wisest men and so on. So a passage will be given like this. You are supposed to read this passage around twice or thrice, and then after that the questions will be given in this particular way. The first thing, the king sent an invitation to Birbal to visit Iran because Birbal was very rich, Birbal was very brave, Birbal was very wise. So the correct option being Birbal was very wise. So you will have a question based on the extract, and then the MCQs will follow. Similarly, you will have around 6 questions like this, and out of those 6 questions, you will have to attempt any 5. Okay, similar questions will follow. Okay, like these. Next, after this, after the reading skills will be your writing skills, which will be again of 10 marks. In writing skills, you will have a letter writing, notice writing, and a story writing. So first and foremost, this is the format for a letter writing, for your informal letter. You will write down your own address, date, and then your dear name of the person, my dear friend, Abhishek, whatsoever, then body of the letter, then your lovingly, and then name of the sender. Then at the end, you will write out your own name. Okay, and this is the format for the formal letter, official letter. First, your address, then date, then the person you are writing to, his address, subject, salutation, body, and then complimentary closure, your sincerely, and then you have to write your name. Next is MCQ-based questions on informal letter. Again, you're not going to get to write down the entire letter, but you're going to write down the, but you're going to get the questions based on the informal letter and questions like, how would you address the recipient of an informal letter? And you will have four options. Dear Mr., my dear sir, dear ma'am, hello sir, or hello ma'am. Okay, in informal letter, your option will be my dear. So this is the format for the question that you're going to get in the letter writing. Okay, again, there is another question. Where do you write the address when you are writing an informal letter? So at the top of the letter, obviously. MCQ based on formal letter. Again, if you are writing a complaint letter to your local council, what is the best way to end the letter? The options are there, and then the option B will be the correct one. I look forward to hearing from you as soon as possible. Okay, then what would you say in the opening part of a formal letter? Again, a question, and then again the option that is to be chosen from the given series. Next one, these were the type of questions that you can get. Now we have a different type of question. In this question, the entire letter will be given, and then blanks will be left at certain places. Like you can see the blank given below the receiver's address, that is for the subject. So they'll ask you to fill in the blank, and you will have to choose the correct option out of these all options given there. Okay. Next is the format for the notice writing, and then the notice writing consists of all these parts there. Body that starts from title, body, date, time, and then authorize the signatures of the authority. Okay, the MCQ based, the heading of this notice should be, you have to choose it from the correct option. Brief and catchy will be the correct option. Okay, then which of these is the most suitable way to start the body of the notice? When you have the options given there, you are supposed to choose the correct option out of these given there. Again, in the notice also, you might get the entire notice, and then you might get the blanks as given there, and you will have to fill in those blanks. You'll get the options, and you'll have to choose the correct options to fill in those blanks. Okay. Then you have the story writing, title, beginning, introduction, plot, conflicts, and the conclusion. Okay. So MCQ based on the story, the themes of the story may be happy, sad, neutral, all of these. Okay. So it can be all of these. So again, the question from story writing, before reading a story, you must read the dash first. It's up to you. History, summary, title, all of the above. The title is the correct option. And then again, in the notice writing, you might get the story like this, and then you will have a blank there. So you'll have to fill in the blank choosing the right option. Okay. Next, the moral of the story. This is very important. This is a very important question. If you're going to get the story writing part, then this question is definitely going to be there. Okay. And you have to choose the moral of the story out of the options given there. Next part is grammatical skills, that it will carry 10 marks, and the questions will be given in this way. Like, for example, what type of sentence gives an order, a command, or a direction? And the options are given right there. Okay, and then do you dash chocolate milk? Do you like, likes, be like, liking? Do you like chocolate milk is the correct option. So this is how the MCQs from the grammar part are going to be given. Okay, you will get a question, and then the four options will follow. As you can see on the screen there. The part D is the literature part. Then again, the poem, the poet of the poem, A House is a Home, is William Shakespeare, Rabindranath Tagore, Lorraine M. Halley, or William Scout. So you have to choose the correct option out of these. Okay, so this is how the questions from literature are going to be placed in the question paper. The name of the poet or the author are very important. Or the writer rather, and then who did Patrick's homework, Patrick himself, Patrick's mother, and for Patrick's friend. So again, you have to choose the right answer. Next is pick the correct meaning of the, that is 19-hood, the ignorant person, a video game, amazed, or sick, or scared. So you have to choose the correct option, that is Nintendo. Okay, Nintendo is the correct word. Okay, as it was not visible. Nintendo is the correct word. So you have to choose the correct option here. Unscramble the letter. Then there's the series of words are given, and you have to unscramble them and form the correct word. Okay. And save me. Don't give me back to the cat. And then I grant you a wish. I promise you. Who said this to whom? Again, a question can be thrown in such a way where you have to say, or where you have to write down, or where you have to take the correct option about who said the following lines to whom, and you are supposed to choose from the options given below. Okay, so this is how your question paper is going to be like. But it's completely going to be the MCQ type question paper. There will be no descriptive questions like the question and answer you do in your copy. You will be given a question, then you will be given four different options, and you will have to choose from the right option. Okay. And if anyone comes across any problem, you may bring it up in the class. Your teachers will assist you on that. Okay. Okay. Thank you, students. Stay home and stay safe.